presentation is on phase inversion and viscosity and type flow by Laura Edwards and Dhurjati Prasad Chakrabarti. If you have any questions regarding this presentation, please feel free to contact me. My email address is laura.edwards@9.edu. Multiphase flow is the general term used to define the simultaneous flow of two or more phases. It is being encountered in many industries. Therefore, the knowledge of the hydrodynamics of flow is significant. Emulsions, or the dispersion of one immiscible phase into another, are found in oil production and processing facilities where crude oil can be found to be mixed with water in the presence of naturally occurring emulsifiers. The change of continuous phase from oil to water or water to oil is termed as phase inversion, referencing Chakrabarti, Das and the Das, 2006. Figure 1 shows a cross-sectional view of air, oil and water flow in a pipe. Figure 1A on the left shows air with water continuous phase, and figure 1B on the right shows air and oil continuous phase. In this work, no emphasis is given to primary inversion points. However, the work is done to check the effects of phase inversion on flow pattern or pressure drop and hold up. The parameters of flow regimes, liquid side pressure drop, liquid hold up and viscosity were investigated. The liquid side pressure drop and hold up were estimated and predicted from existing as well as developed curry regions. Figure 2 shows a schematic representation of the experimental flow loop. Two taps of the manometer with carbon tetrachloride as manometer fluid are attached to the pipe. The test fluids are oil, water, and air. The oil-water dispersion is mixed in the tank. The oil is chosen as soybean oil to avoid any environmental hazard of petroleum oil. Also, high viscosity, like crude oil, is observed during flow. The entire pipe section is made of PVC except for the transparent visual section, where the flow regimes are observed. The pump liquid is allowed to circulate and make it flow back into the tank. The liquid flow rate is set by the liquid water meter R1. The gas is sent from a compressor and passed through the gas water meter R2, where the air flow rate is set. The air flow rate is varied between 0.05 and 0.5 meters per second. The runs are then repeated for liquid flow rates up to 1.25 meters per second. Of 40% and 65% were studied. The flow regimes observed are shown in Figure 3. The flow patterns showed gas flowing at the top of the pipe with the liquid flowing at the bottom. The stratified smooth or SS flow pattern occurred when the gas-liquid interface was smooth. The stratified wavy or SW flow pattern has a wavy gas-liquid interface. The stratified wavy with ripples or SWR flow regime contains ripples between higher amplitude waves. The flow regime is classified as dispersed slug, elongated bubble, or DSEB flow when the liquid occupied the entire pipe and intermittently long air bubbles occupied the top of the pipe. The flow regime was classified as plug, dispersed gas, or PLDG flow when the liquid occupied the entire pipe and periodically small air bubbles would occupy the top of the pipe. Figures 4 and 5 show the flow pattern maps at 40% and 65% oil cuts respectively. The change in flow pattern at these oil cuts may be attributed to the increased effective liquid viscosity upon addition of the oil. This increased viscosity is said to have dampened the flow instability. The applied flow instability, that is the air flow, is not enough to allow the shear effects of the air to overcome the gravitational and viscous effects of the liquid. 40% to 65% oil cuts, the elongated bubble region becomes narrow to give a bigger area of the plug flow pattern on the flow regime map. In the present study, oil and water together behaves as a single phase, and as a result it resembles a two-phase system. All studies and the theories are inferred based on two phases, liquid and gas. However, since the liquid phase is a mixed phase, the effect on stratification is considered. With the change of oil percentage, or in other words, with the change in viscosity in the liquid phase, a different flow regime emerges in the stratified pattern. This unusual part of the study makes this work out of the ordinary. The flow regime phenomena can be attributed to the fact that the oil and water are mixed into a dispersion, with the oil being dispersed into the water or vice versa, as fine drops that coalesced only at rest. The dispersion appeared to be in equilibrium, since the oil did not fully separate from the dispersed phase. This might be due to the intensive mixing in the tank that prevents coalescence of the droplets after being fed to the test section. It can be said that the system behaves like a gas liquid two-phase flow, which can justify the use of the weighted average liquid properties. Within the liquid, it moves from water continuous to oil continuously. However, the variation of viscosity is not an expression of adequate property. Moreover, the viscosities at different water cuts have been applied for completion of the momentum balance equation as described in equations 1 to 11 by Keitel and Ducklow, 1976. No better result is obtained by doing so, to justify the change in flow regime with different oil percentage. The change in velocity gradient with respect to viscosity is needed to be looked at further analytically. To estimate liquid holdup or pressure drop, Keitel and Ducklow 1976 theory is extended for calculation. The flow of three fluids, water, oil, and gas, is considered. The water is heavier than the oil and occupies the bottom of the pipe. The oil flows in the middle and the gas at the top for specified flow. A momentum balance for each phase can be written as shown in equations 1 to 3, where the subscripts are W for water, O for oil, G for gas, and L for oil and water dispersion. The symbol A is cross-sectional area, rho is density, Q is pressure, and beta is the inclination angle. For the present case, three shear stresses are needed to be solved: tau L, tau G, and tau I. Tau L is the shear stress acting on the wall rested by the liquid phase SL. Tau G is the shear stress acting on the wall rested by the gas phase SG. And the tau I is the shear stress acting on the gas-liquid interface SI. In this present case, as oil is dispersed into water or vice versa, the dispersed phase is considered as the single liquid phase. Physical properties of liquid are taken as additive properties of oil and water, except viscosity, depending on their fraction. Viscosity is calculated based on Edwards et al. 2018. The momentum balance for the liquid phase will be as shown in equation 4. Equations 5 to 7 give expressions for the shear stresses, where the symbol U is velocity. Equation 8 gives the expression for F, which is the fission factor. For the shear stresses between the liquids or gas and the pipe surface, the friction factors FL, FW, and FI can be approximated by the correlation, where the parameter C in equation 8 is equal to 0.046 and N equals 0.2 for turbulent flow, and for laminar flow, C equals 16 and N equals 1. The Reynolds number with the concept of hydraulic diameter is defined as in equations 9 and 10, where mu is the viscosity. The expression for liquid viscosity, which is mu L, is shown in equation 11, where X is oil percentage and the liquid viscosity has the units of centipoise. For the interfacial gas-liquid shear stress, we used a constant value of Fi equals 0.014, but if the value of Fg is greater than Fi, then Fi equals Fg is used. Pressure drop can be eliminated from equations 3 and 4 to yield equation 12. Equation 12 is solved to get holdup and pressure drop. The experimental and predicted pressure drop is shown in figure 6. Figure 7 shows experimental and predicted holdup. In some cases, prediction exceeded plus or minus 31% and may be due to the sudden change in viscosity of the liquid phase as well as deviation from ideality. The reason may also be due to flow pattern variation with oil percentage. In the present study, the liquid is a dispersion of oil and water as well as inverted water dispersion. Pressure drop and liquid holdup are also compared with previous theory and our predictions of stratification. The experimental data were found to deviate from predictions, even exceeding plus or minus 31%. Addition of oil and water increases the region of the flow regime map that is occupied by plugs. Nevertheless, this phenomenon is not following any consistent pattern. The flow regime study was performed primarily by normal video camera and image processing. A recommendation is to use a high-speed camera, a conductivity probe, or optical probe to identify flow regimes in a better way. The following are the references utilized for this study. Thank you very much for your kind attention. If you have any questions regarding this presentation, please feel free to contact me. My email address is laura.edwards@my.ue.edu. Thank you.